Hello everyone, how's it going, and welcome back to Enderal. So last time, we continued our magical journey towards the city of Ark. We finally arrived after a whole lot of effort trying to get Jesper here because he kept stopping and starting following us continuously. His AI was completely broken. Now, some people suggested that was probably because I quick traveled with him in the first place to, let's have a look at the map so I can show you. Essentially, we started out from Riverville, which is all the way over there. I think I quick traveled to here, the Tavern at the Penny on the road, or whatever it's called. Yeah. Basically, I think quick traveling from there to there probably was what caused his AI to break. The thing is, it really shouldn't have done. You know, in regular Skyrim, you can do that. So, I mean, I get that it was probably my fault, but at the same time, if they didn't disable quick traveling in the first place, we wouldn't have those problems. But anyway, so we're in Ark, we're gonna explore the city. We also have a quest to kill some kind of a troll that's been pestering some chicks, horses or sheep or something, and she said she's gonna give us a donkey called Whirlwind in return. Damn right we're gonna do that quest! I want a donkey named motherfucking Whirlwind. So, first of all, we're gonna check out the city. It might take the whole episode, it might take two or three or something, I don't know. It depends how big it is, how many quests and things are here.
My sir.
Hello,
do
Milbert.
Do you have a moment? I think the two of us could do business together.
Why, yes I do, Milbert! You're a merchant, aren't you? I'm looking to trade.
What? Oh, yes, sure. What do you need?
What are you buying? What are you selling? You have a bunch of books. Bunch of balls. I will buy them. Yes. Yes. I will buy these archery books. I will buy the elementarism, terrorism, whatever. I'll buy those. I'll buy entropy. I'll buy the light magic books. Did I not buy all of them? Yes, I would like all of them. Oh. I can't afford them, can I? Man, we're broke already, really? Holy shit! God fucking damn! Alright, I guess we'll buy these. Man, alright, I guess we're out. Alright, whatever. So what do you need, pal? But what the...
What?
What
the... Oh, yes, sure.
Skyrim, what
do
you
doing?
Need? I know we're not playing Skyrim, but it's Skyrim's fault. What do you need?
Well, it is actually quite simple. But since you were kind enough not to just ignore me and walk by as the others did, I would like to show my gratitude for that first.
Hooray!
You travel a lot, don't you? I can tell by the mud on your boots. Here, one of these books might come in handy on your journeys. Which one do you prefer?
I'll take that one. Crafting book for alchemy. Or do we want craftsmanship, or do we want enchantment? I don't know. I don't actually know. I mean, sure, alchemy. We'll go with that.
Splendid. Say, would you happen to be interested in earning yourself some more coins?
Yes, or, I'm poor.
Even better, more books like those?
Also that,
there
yes.
There's something I need help with.
You want me to give you a Hummer in a back alley for money? Because I'll do it. I'll do it. I might be. What's troubling you, friend?
I have a problem. And this problem is called Celia, which happens to be my sister. Where should I start?
Is she hot?
You know, I am one of those people who wasn't given everything by fate. Quite the contrary, in fact. When I was a child, the village I grew up in, Foomville, was ambushed by bandits.
Foomville.
And both my father and my mother died during the attack.
Are you Bruce Wayne? Let's skip the chatter. What do you want?
Believe me, I wouldn't tell you this if it weren't necessary. Fact is, my sister and I dealt with this event differently. We managed to flee the attack and make it to Ark, where the guards, of course, threw us into the Undercity. But while I tried to honor my father's heritage by using the little I could from our savings by setting up a business, she preferred to wallow in her misery instead.
I know the kind.
She got to know the wrong people and has, since then, never done a single bit of honest work. Frankly, she's a dust addict. Day and night, she does nothing else but rot in those drinking holes in the Undercity and blows what little money she makes on her drage.
No,
of course, she is still my sister. So all of these years, I paid her rent so she doesn't have to sleep on the streets. However, things have changed. Recently, she started using our father's heritage to pay for her addiction. And I will not accept that.
I don't blame you. Also, your lip sync might be a little off. Can you talk to a god about this? Yeah, go tattle on her. Let me get this straight. She blows your money to buy a drage? Which I think is drugs? Let's go with this one first. What do you mean she's a dust addict? I'm an outlander. It's gotta be drugs, obviously.
Of course, you wouldn't know that. Glimmer cap dust, the blue bliss, or however you want to call it. It's a drug, a dangerous one. Apparently, it makes you feel as if you're walking the eternal paths. But it also kills you quicker than the sunfire.
Tell her just to lick toads. It's cheaper and less dangerous. Okay, so she blows your money on Drage.
Well, technically it's our money. Basically, it was a share our father had in a small business here. He was so proud of it, you wouldn't believe it. Luckily enough, I managed to save that paper from the bandits and turned it in at the bank a few years ago, after I realized how valuable it was.
Uh-huh.
Since then, it has turned into quite a formidable sum. Nothing huge, of course, but enough to save my business from bankruptcy. You understand? In theory, it is our money, but without me, she would probably have sold it for a bottle of ale, and I won't let her spit on our father's heritage that way.
I see, and why don't you just talk to her? Why am I gonna do it?
Oh, believe me, I did. Which is why she simply hid the key to our safe in the bank somewhere that I couldn't find it. So, long story short, this is where you come in.
Dude, your sister sounds like a bitch.
To give me that key. How you do it is up to you. But if you succeed, it won't be to your disadvantage.
What if I murder her? Because I might do that, you know. Fair enough, I'll help you. Where can I find her? Probably toughing some Drage somewhere. Taking the blue bliss.
Anywhere there's rats and dust. But she spends most of her time in the false dog in the Undercity. One of those dumps I told you about. Just come back to me once you've found something.
Alright, pal, I don't know how to get to the Undercity, but, you know, when I do, I'll look for her in the Dusty Dog, or whatever it was called. Alright, so, it's nighttime, so I suspect most of these are gonna be shut. So we need to find, like, an inn or something so we can sleep to make it day. What is the gatehouse, exactly? Is this, like, a guardhouse, but they've just named it different? Alright. So what the hell's going on here? Hello, friends. You want some?
Greetings.
You freaking want some? Alright, he seems friendly. I'm new to the city and I'm looking for work. Do you know where I can find any, pal?
Let me think. Ah, yes. This young woman who owns the gallery in the South Quarter looked a little distraught when I last saw her. I think business isn't going so well. Maybe you could try to talk to her, see if there's anything you can do.
Holy shit, useful information from a guard. I'll be jiggered! You want some as well?
Blessed.
Any news?
Well, I take it you know of Grandmaster Aranthiel's return already. Word has it he spent half an eternity in prison in your country.
You see that?
But let me tell you, that man hasn't lost an inch of his resolve. Hang on. I know you.
What the bloody hell?
What the heck do you think you're doing? You've committed a crime.
Easy there, I'll pay the fine for this fucking money.
But it is not the righteous path you to repent on. Go to the town.
He shanked the fuck out of me! Dude, not cool, alright? So obviously I wasn't supposed to go in there because it was nighttime. I think the game's crashed, by the way. I wasn't supposed to go in there because it was nighttime. So what you decided would be the best idea was to give me crime gold and then kill me in the middle of a bloody conversation. I'm gonna Alt-F4 the game. I'll be right back. Oh, never mind. I guess it fixed itself. So, we're not allowed in here right now. See, this is the problem. It seems like in Enderal, as opposed to Skyrim, if it's nighttime and you're not allowed in there, you can go in there anyway. Like, the doors don't lock. Is the game crashing again? What the bloody hell is going on? Like, the doors don't seem to lock. So you can go in even though you're not allowed in. So you're trespassing, but you don't necessarily realize that you're trespassing until it's too bloody late. Bit of a silly way of doing things, gotta be honest. What is this? True women. Fight for freedom, peace, and the righteous path. Women of Enderal, join the city guard. Oh, so they're trying to recruit bitches. That's hot. Alright, so what is this? South Quarter, under city marketplace. Sun Temple. Noble's quarters in the harbor. We're just gonna look around. We'll see, you know, we're just gonna wing it. Well then again, does any of this lead to like an inn? Where would the inn be? Maybe even in the noble's quarters or the south quarters? Struggling this way? I just want an inn so I can make a date. That's all I want. A little frustrating. New location discovered. We found the foreign quarter. Is this where the foreigners hang out?
You're a foreigner, aren't you? I wish I'd have crossed the Red Sea once.
Oh, man.
I've seen Kira, the Grand Bazaar. Ah, well.
What?
You have the most forceful voice I've ever heard in my life, sir.
Good evening.
Good evening. I'm an old man.
You don't speak. You don't speak
my
at all.
My sir. They just don't respect the elders anymore.
Wait a minute. This looks like it might be a bar. What does it say? Once magic runneth through your veins, be wary not to go astray. The order's help you shall then seek, and Malphus's words you need to heed. Else your magic will become wild, and death will soon make you its child. Oh, lovely. What is this? Embrace your inner child with Tahuti. Every night, channel your voice of the new age by dancing, blah, blah, blah. All right, I don't care about that shit. Well, is this an inn? Looks like an inn. The Dancing Nomad. Alright. I just need a freaking bed so I can make it daytime so we're not trespassing every time we walk in a bloody building. That's all I want, really. And some quicker load screens. Then we'll go miss. Beautiful. Alright. Look, this guy's going ham on the plant.
You're not from around here, are you? I know that accent.
No, I'm not. Why does everyone keep making a point of that, you fucking rude asshole?
Huh? Wait. I think I know you. You work for the Order, don't you? Why are those wild mages up in the temple?
Look at him go! He's a bloody ventriloquist with that flute!
With it just doesn't add up.
Oh, you're not from around here.
That looks hilarious with that flute in his mouth. He's also wearing, almost said Cesaro. Cesaro is a wrestler. Cicero's gear.
In the bed.
Yo, sorry. Can I have a bed, motherfucker?
Malphas's blessings.
Yeah, I'm looking for a room for tonight.
And our room's looking for you. It's Snow Ark Noble Quarter, but it's warm and clean. Want it?
I couldn't give a fuck, I just wanted to be daytime.
Good.
10 pennies, I'll do it.
We'll open up the room for you. And please, no shady business. We walk the righteous path in here.
Look, if I
want
to masturbate in your room, I'll do it. Whilst I'm renting it, it's mine. Also, I would like something to drink.
What do you got? I need something stiff.
A little bit of this and that. Why not take a look?
Well, I'll take a look. What are you selling? What are you buying?
I don't need your shit. Get out of here.
Come back.
Alright, so where's me room? What's going on with the text at the bottom?
You're an outlander, aren't you?
Malphas's
blessings.
Is this two people inside each other? Or is this the same dude? He's doubled up. That's two dudes. Yo.
You're an outlander, aren't you?
Yes, I am. I just don't see the fucking point.
Is it that obvious, old man?
Only if you know what to look for. I'm one myself, so I do. Balhazer, pleased to make your acquaintance. Tell me, if you're new in this city, are you perchance also looking for work?
Yes. Seems to be a lot of it around here, though.
Excuse me. What was I saying? I'm looking for a hand.
Yeah, go on. Maybe. What'd you have in mind?
It's simple. I want you to find something for me. You know, I'm a healer, just like my father was, and my grandfather before that.
Alright, I didn't ask for your life story.
When he came to this country, he did so because he had been hired by an Arca noble woman.
Guess I'm getting it anyway.
A lady who valued science and the arts of healing. In any case, my grandfather spent a large portion of life working for this lady in an old abandoned fort near the now deserted village of Fogville. Together with a good dozen other Apocatharg, he planned for my father to succeed him. But before he had the chance to, the Mushroom Plague occurred.
Alright, holy shit, this really is like an old man story. It just keeps going, Mushroom Plague? You mean the plague that destroyed the Whisperwood?
Yes, that one.
Why do I know of this?
The spores of those mushrooms have literally sucked all the life from the forest and its surroundings. Plus, they are a threat to everyone who comes close.
Mushrooms bad, got it. I see. Did your grandfather's work have anything to do with that plague and shrooms?
It does seem likely, doesn't it? Both my father and I have asked my grandfather this question too.
Look at that chick over there, look at her go.
But he has denied it. The plague was a magical phenomenon, a freak of nature, no more, no less. Those were his words.
Uh-huh.
However, I've made some troubling discoveries which have led me to doubt that. I believe the plague might have been fabricated.
My god, fabricated? But why would anyone want to do that?
Well, this is exactly what I want you to find out. Unfortunately, the noblewoman who my grandfather worked for has long been dead, and she was the last in their bloodline, so I couldn't find any answers there. But the old fortress where they worked still stands. Go there and look for answers. If my grandfather had something to do with this, I want to know.
Dude, those two dancing over there are fucking hilarious. Like, they're in perfect unison. Also, he's dancing incredibly girly, because that's probably supposed to be a girl dance. I mean, look at him go. I mean, you know, maybe he's just a very feminine man. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm just saying, it's funny. Why don't you go see for yourself? Why is this so important to you? We'll go with that.
Isn't that obvious?
I don't know.
I want to understand. You know, we Azalines believe in the debt of blood. If my grandfather committed a crime, it is my responsibility to atone for it.
Oh, no one cares.
Plus, I believe that if there was a way to, well, to cure that plague, it is hidden within that fortress. Whatever harm the mushrooms can do, they can also reverse it. My father never cared much about all this, but I'm different. If there's one thing I want to achieve in my life, then it's... clarity.
Alright then. I'm not gonna ask him that. I mean, he's an old man. That's gonna be his excuse. Like, I'm so old! Fine then, I'll see what I can do. We're gonna find this fortress, and what do you need me to look for?
Reports, scrolls, samples of their work. Anything that could be of relevance. Just look around. Do you have a map?
Yes, I do. It helps to have a map.
Here, the fortress should be in this area. Best you take Myra to Fogville. In the village harbor, there was a hut where my grandfather lived when he was off duty. Chances are, you'll find a key to the fortress there. Good luck, and thank you. If you have found the material, you can find me in the Undercity, near the old waterworks. My laboratory is there.
My laboratory. Alright, I don't trust this old dude. I think he just wants us to find these things for him, and then he's gonna, you know, create some kind of potion that's gonna kill everyone.
You should go to the Whisperwood and see what you can find in the old fortress. I'll wait for you in the Undercity.
I like the way you got up and sat straight back down. You're crazy, old man. You're crazy.
What do you want?
Hello.
Malphas's blessings.
Malphas's blessings. Alright, so... front quarter, where's my bed? Where is my bed? I want my baby bed. Is this my bedroom? Get out!
An outlander.
She's mine!
Isn't this
fucking
nice?
Get out! Get out!
No, you
hello. Talk to me. Talk to me.
An outlander.
I mean, let's be honest, that's not why you were hired.
Isn't this nice?
Alright, shut up. Can I have my own prostitute? I mean, like, come on. Why wasn't there an option to hire one of those? Maybe it's upstairs. What is this? Discipline's magic elementarism. Or whatever that word is supposed to be.
I just don't see the
there's a bit of a weird situation we got going on here, 4 1/4. Anyone? Expert door. Gotta be here, yep. I had a feeling the one with the bloody hole in the wall. Yeah.
Well.
Shitty ass room that I get. Alright. So, it is 11 PM. Let's wait around until. Well, not that bloody long. Let's wait around until about. It's gonna take us to what, 8 PM? Yeah. 8 AM rather. We'll go with that. That seems good. 8 AM, I think it should be right by that point. Chances are this would be one of those days where it's foggy as shit, so we won't see anything, but at least things should be open. And it did say, wait, is it 7? No, it's 8, okay. I think it did say in one of the load screen tips that most places open at 8 AM. So it should be good. Hello, Doria the Explorer. Slow down, champ. She's got nothing to say. Alright, calm down. I'm losing my mouse right now. It feels really stiff. Don't like it, man. Don't like it. Oh, God. Roast pork, governor! You still down there with that prostitute? Son of a bitch. Alright. There's the old man. Yo, someone left this coin purse. Get out of here. It's mine. What? I can't steal. What? Why can't I steal it?
You should go into the Whisperwood and see.
Why am I walking now? What happened? Whoa! Didn't mean to press that button, but I do think we actually have a meditation point to use, so I guess it works out. Do we have a point to use? Let's have a look at our hero menu. We do, a memory point, that's right. Let me go back in the controls for a second here, because I can never bloody remember how you turn running on and off. So I'll always run. Is it left alt? Is that what I hit? Did I hit left alt? Okay, there we go. Alright, so, we were going into the elemental thing. I guess we need to get this one next. Reduce the mana cost. Sure. Alright, nothing too interesting, but we got it now. It's done. We didn't forget. So let's go back. I should start using more of these books. I guess we did just buy a bunch. So let's use them now before I forget. They're going to be in consumables, I think. Yeah, here we go. Just use the archery books. I wish you could click them fast. Oh, God, I didn't mean to use that. Oh, well, I used an alchemy book. Suck it up. Archery. I guess we were going with alchemy anyway, since that's the book I asked for. I'll think about block. It's something I rarely use, so I probably won't worry about that. It depends if we get, like, block perks and what have you, and maybe a really good shield. I don't know, man. For now, I'm just gonna use all the magic books, really. And we'll decide later which type of armor we're going for. And this psionic. And, you know, also alchemy. We'll go with, like, alchemy and magic for now. Alright, so, about this coin purse that for some reason I can't steal. Like, you can't interact with this. Like, what the hell?
Yes, of course you'd
look, you
that.
Can't pick it up! What's up with that?
That's just
wait, interact gambling table. Everything just sit down if you want to play. Hang on.
The old days.
Is this like a mini game? Hang on. Interact gambling. How do I click on that? Oh god, he got up! Son of a... Just sit down. There you go, right. Interact. Gambling table is currently unoccupied. Come back in the evening or night to play. Oh. Interesting, though. Very interesting.
Maid! Stew!
God, controls. Anyone? It's so confusing switching between this and Morrowind. I'm just gonna double check and see if there's anyone else around here who might have, like, a quest or something. Give any information?
Blessings.
Nope. Alright. Well, yes. It's daytime. Let's go outside and see if we can actually, get some shit done. Like I say, it's probably gonna take at least a couple of episodes for us to explore this place, because, I mean, we've been gone for like 20 minutes already, and we've barely moved, you know? If there's quests and dialogue all over the place, it's gonna consume a lot of time. So just strap yourselves in. This is the way Jason plays RPGs. I ain't gonna rush nothing, you know? I'm in no rush to finish this. I don't see the reason to. Alright, we're outside. The frame rate is horrible, but, you know, I kind of expect this. Look at it, it's bloody beautiful. Reminds me of one of the cities from Oblivion. I want to say Chadenhall? I think maybe Chadenhall. Then again, I did have that city, like, heavily modded to look different, so... Regular Chadenhall probably didn't look like that. Also,
why?
I might be getting the name wrong.
You there. Don't look at me like that. Looking for trouble, eh?
What if I am, drunkie?
Stop ignoring me!
What's going on with his head? What's your problem, Drunky McMonkey?
You bloody flood your eyes on me, woman. you think I haven't noticed, don't you? You say sorry at once, so I'll smack your mouth. So,
how are you? Wait, your woman? Who is she?
Oh, that you'd like to know.
I'm so confused.
So you can deduce her, me Bernadette. Don't bloody think I'm stupid.
So we need to bet his woman now. Alright. We can attack him. Enough, you need a beating. And this, dear friends, is why we should take it easy on the booze. That sounds like something that sounds exactly like something I would say. I'm gonna do that. I'm sorry, I have to.
Why, you think you can mock me? Alright. You'll regret this.
Do I get to punch the shit out of you? Yeah, I do. It's clever time! Can't you, like, double tap it so he does, like, a little combo-y thing? Oh god, we're kind of losing. Yeah, give him the old 1-2! Oh god, I fucking hate an innocent son of a bitch, I hate everything. No!
Wait a second.
Damn it!
I don't know who you think you
shut
are.
Up. But no shut one. Up!
I do whatever the fuck I want. Show off.
Alright, let's reload the game and we'll get back to brawling with this guy. 1 second. I'll bring you back in when I've aggroed him again. I knew someone was gonna walk in front of us. It always happens. Alright, so you got involved in a brawl. Is this something about no weapons, nobody dies? Oh, that's a little unfortunate. I swear you can do like a combo with your fists. I thought you just held down like both the buttons, like the way you draw. There you go. Not the easiest thing to do. Alright, so no one walk in front, please. I'm teaching this drunk man a lesson.
I'll beat it into you, you son of a bitch. Oh, you are getting dumped, sir. Teabag of justice.
All right. Should just backed off, shouldn't you, son?
Okay, just leave me alone. Damn bullies.
No, you're such a bully. Oh.
Poor baby, I should fuck you up right now. Who are you?
Morales blessings, my friend.
So, you're from Calais, right? Did you flee the war over there, champ?
Well, flee isn't exactly the right word for it. I call it tactical relocalization. Only a stupid businessman will try to sell spices amidst a civil war.
I like your accent. Don't know what it is, but I like it. What exactly caused that war? I've heard about it, but never knew from a countryman.
Oh, well, after those rumors about the Lightborn's death started, the council members must have thought, now's the time for power struggles. Very stupid, if you ask me. I'm very bad for the economy. Thank the sun, I was one of the few who fled early enough. But this madness has cost far too many lives. Far too many.
Far too many. Okay, so what do you sell, buddy?
Spices, rugs, delicacies, only the best. Straight from Kilay.
I don't really need a rug. I don't have a house to put it in. So you lied to me, all you sell is dates. They're kind of expensive. I have 10 gold. Damn, I can't even afford a single date. Wow, we are broke. How do you know I'm an adventurer? Start again. How do you know I'm an adventurer? Where's the button? God damn it!
What one wears tells more than a thousand words, as we Kileans like to say. You are surrounded by a feeling of an adventurer as much as a keeper is surrounded by a feeling of honor. And I think I might just have something in stock, which could be to your liking.
What would that be? Dates?
A potion. One of my friends in the Blue Islands Coalition gave it to me with the last delivery. And he said they took it from pirates. Of course, that sparked my interest, and so I asked an apothecary to examine it. And now brace yourself. He said this potion grants its user extraordinary powers. Here, take a look. Beautiful, isn't it? It can be yours for only 200 pennies.
I spent all my money. I'm sorry.
Oh, how determined. But as you wish.
Shit. Alright, I guess we can probably get that another time. Let's have a look, to make
what
sure.
One wears tells more than a thousand.
Yeah, okay,
words.
It looks like we can come back and get the potion another time. Okay, so when we get some money, we'll try and remember that. He's
by
just
a
gonna keep talking to himself, isn't he?
As much
hey,
as
baby, I have no money. You are wearing quite a lot of makeup.
You there! You look as if you could do with a fine loaf of our unrivaled fresh and tasty bread. I can see it in your eyes.
That guy's still talking. Show me the unrivaled bread of yours.
Certainly. A pleasure for the young and the old, for the tall and the small. See for yourself.
I don't like you. You're far too chipper. Date cake. There's a lot of dates going on around here. Goat milk. Dude, we can't afford, like, any of this shit. We can afford a piece of salt. Two pieces of salt. Nothing else. Not a damn thing. We are one coin short of a bloody pretzel. This is how poor we are right now. Can I sell some food or something? Where's my stuff? Yeah, nothing really has that much value, does it? I can sell venison for 8 gold. Bloody hell. We need to do some quests, man. We are poor as hell. So what is it that makes your bread so unrivaled, fresh and tasty? I like your baps. That's slang for breasts. You're welcome.
Well, it is fresh and it is tasty. What are you getting at?
I'm trying to flirt with you. You have failed, woman, because you're too stupid to understand it. Also, take off that makeup. You look like a fucking clown. Jesus. So my HP is not in good condition, but that's okay, because hopefully we won't have to find anyone else anytime soon. What is this? Don't know, but it looks
noble
cool.
Noble citizens of Ark, lick your lips in untamed desire as the ambrosial
is this
smells
you again?
Of our unrivaled fresh
it's
and tasty
her again.
Shut
up about your damn bread, woman. Hello, you're some kind of a maid.
Is it important?
You have a name. Is that a Ula Feather Dance?
Is it important?
Yeah, okay. Apparently it's not important. It's not important enough for you to speak to me. Right. I was trying to stick to the main path for now, and last, what is this? Backery? I don't know what a backery is. Love the music, by the way. Hello.
Walk blessed.
Anything to trade or found some stuff?
Trade? Huh. Well, I guess it depends on what you need.
I need to sell some things, man. I'm very, very poor right now. Okay, you're just a general person. You have 150 gold. Look, I'm gonna need more than that, dog. I'm sorry, I'm gonna need more than that. I'm not carrying an awful lot. I can sell you these chain gloves for a whole 2 coins. I can sell you these hauberks for 5 apiece. Boy, aren't we making a lot of money. I guess maybe at this rate, your 150 probably gonna be enough. You can almost afford this hood of elementarism. How do you even say that? Elementarism? Terrorism? Look, it's elemental, right? It's an elemental hood. Iron shield. We don't need that, do we? Because we have leather shields. So let's get rid of 2 of those. Get rid of the iron shield. Leather helmet we don't need. Old robe probably don't need. Old vagrant hood don't need. Okay, well, we're getting some money. We have a spare backpack. Good. Looking good to me for now. I might sell this. What the hell is it? This thing. Yeah, that's right. We have 2 of them. Let's sell 1 of them. I hope you don't need, like, more. So these poisons, yes. I'm not one for using poisons. Oh, you only have 11 coins. Okay, well, we're breaking her. This is good. This one has no value? What? What the bloody hell? What the bloody hell? You know, I'll take those. And you have 6 gold left. Do I have something? I could sell you this for 6 gold. Beautiful. All right, so we got 150 out of her. What?
Safe travels.
Safe travels, Mendio. All right, who are you?
Hello.
Walk blessed, my friend.
It's another Grenbeard.
You look disheartened.
Oh.
I have just the right thing for you.
You look important.
A visit to our gallery. Dozens of beautiful paintings by different artists, each of them a treat for the eye.
Do you want to stop whilst you're talking to me?
Come now, for tomorrow you may not have a chance. No? I thought so. Then have a nice day. Come
you don't
now,
sound
for
very
tomorrow
motivated.
You may not have a chance.
All right, stop,
no,
stop, stop, stop,
so.
Stop,
then
stop,
have a nice
stop,
day.
Stop, stop. What do you mean tomorrow you might have a chance? I take it your gallery isn't going so well.
That's one way to put it. Truth be told, if the Golden Sickle doesn't decide to leave a barrel full of coin on our doorstep tomorrow, we won't be able to pay rent much longer. Especially now that my esteemed mother has decided to play hermit. Wow. Listen to me. A month ago, I would have been too proud to admit this. Now I shouted at a complete stranger.
I had noticed. What does your mother have to do with this?
She's a painter. Our best-selling painter, to be precise. Some people even came from other countries to see her portraits. At least before the war.
Really? What makes her painting so special?
It's hard to describe. She's portrayed half of Ark's nobility by now. At least that's what it feels like. And she does it. The paintings are just so intense. I don't know how else to put it. That's why people are willing to pay a fortune for them. It's crazy if you think about it.
I like her eyes, by the way. Like an awesome shade of green. Your mother plays hermit? What do you mean by that?
Well, what I said. For months, she's not reacted to our letter, nor sent one herself. And what's worse, she hasn't sent us any new paintings. Which is one of the reasons why this place isn't going so well. And in case you wonder why we just don't visit her, my mother was always a little special. And where she resides reflects that. The Dark Valley.
Dun dun dun. I see. You know what? I get around quite a bit. Maybe I could pay this Dark Valley a visit and see if your mother is alright.
You'd do that. That's quite the offer, to be honest. A word of warning in advance. I cannot pay you. That is, unless you're interested in a painting from Prince Myth. But I warn you, they're as bad as his poems.
Maybe your mother can pay me, or maybe you and your mother can pay me at the same time. If you catch my drift. I'm talking about a threesome. Maybe your mother can pay me.
Yes, maybe she can. It might be worth a try. My mother and I, we don't exactly have a good relationship.
Damn it!
But still, I need to know she's all right. You said you travel a lot, so you have a map with you, right? Show me. So, there you go. That's where her hut should be, at least approximately. Good luck, and... thanks.
We are gonna have a shit ton of quests to do when we get out of here. Take it easy, baby. Take it easy. I don't like to see you leave, but I love to watch you walk away. Alright, so what's going on with these two? Hello, aspirant. Hello, aspirant. Hello, aspirant. Hello, aspirant. Fuck you. Alright, so... what's this?
Monsieur?
Ark the Marketplace. Oh, we're too poor for a marketplace. Too poor. We should maybe do some quests before we continue searching around again, because we're too poor for even the marketplace. It almost, to me, is the equivalent of being a hobo and walking past, like, a sandwich shop or something like that. I'm like, oh, I'm so hungry! And there's just everyone in there, like, munching the goddamn sandwiches. I'm gonna walk in there, see people buying and selling shit, and be like, I can't partake because I'm too poor! So, yes. Might search around this area a little bit more. And then... go and do some of those quests, like, for example, the one to get that badass donkey. Because, you know, I want a donkey. Why would I not? You're just a traveler. Yeah, push it, buddy. Don't stop on my account. Who the hell are you?
War on Nehrim. War on Kile. Red madness. The fuck is wrong with this world?
War. War never changes. Oh god, it's one of those terrifying things. I will kill you if you come at me. Look at that face. That is the stuff of nightmares. I mean, it's probably supposed to be cute. It ain't cute. What's up with this? A dead motherfucking chicken. Well, that was weird. Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
How am I supposed to pay that much?
Bloody
cutthroats.
You can't get any momentum on this game. Alright, hang on. Alright, well, whatever. I tried. So yeah, that's a dead chicken. So there seems to be some kind of a farm. I know I'm going out on a limb here, but I think it's a farm. Hello, laborer. I don't know. Just speak to me, baby. Speak to me.
Malfas's blessings.
You're smoking the blue... blue ganja, ain't you?
But... I don't think she would like that.
What I'm trying to say is, stay away from those olive-skinned cutthroats. They lure you in with nice words and big promises, then bang! You put your cross under a contract that makes you a slave for a lifetime.
Oh, but... this isn't nice.
Why aren't you looking at that?
Because they're a greedy pack who have as much decency and path abidingness as a bloody vatir, that's why.
Look at his little baby chicken!
Boy, I am so sick of those fucking glittery liars. If I were the Grand Master, I'd have thrown him out of this country long ago.
This man has very orange hair.
Okay.
Turn around, damn it, it's weird.
Hmm?
Apprentice, what up, laborer?
Wild mages in the Sun Temple? I wonder what's next. A Skaragian keeper? I tell you, everything's going downhill these days.
Is it just me, or did his voice completely change from what he just said then to when he was berating this man? This man with very, very orange hair who looks a little bit like Frodo Baggins. Don't tempt me, Frodo! What the hell are you doing? Why are you throwing flowers at me, Frodo? You're fucking nuts! He's got no shoes on like Frodo as well. Put some shoes on. Oh, that dude in Game of Thrones with no shoes pisses me off. Mostly just because he doesn't wear shoes. Like, just put some fucking shoes on. I don't care what your bullshit reasoning is. Put some shoes on. It's stupid. Hello.
War on Nehrim.
War never changes. What is
this? Alright, everyone shut up. You got nothing interesting to say. Screw Hats, Odds and Ends, Incorporated. Well, I guess it's like Screw Hats, Odds and Ends, Incorporated. Not Screw Hats. Like, they have nothing against hats by the sounds of things. Let's go in the Screw Hats place. Why the hell not? I don't know what this even really means. What is screw exactly? I mean, I know a few things that are screw, but... the hell? Look at that! It piled them all up. Can I knock them over? No, they're not physics-enabled. Lame. Look at this iron pot. This is custom. This was not in Skyrim originally. I know that much. Look at it! Look at that! I can't pick it up! Son of a bitch! Son of a... can I pick this up? I can't, like, pick anything up right now. I don't know why. Hello? What is this weird place? Looks very cool. This is an awesome design here. Don't you think? Look at this shit! Looks badass! Can I use these beds? I can. Interesting. Free beds. You know, let's wait around for an hour. Sleep for an hour to get our HP back. Gotta get it for free when we can. That's just outside? No, it's not outside. No, it's not. Cause it... Okay, so it's... It's a different cell. Oh. Your lockpick abilities are too low to open this lock. You need to unlock the appropriate memories beforehand. Oh, son of a bitch. So they changed the lockpicking. It didn't work that way in Skyrim, I don't think. I'm pretty sure you could pick any lock at any level. It was just way harder. I think. Alright, fair enough. Fair enough. There's some piggies over there. What? 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 So they're... Yeah, they're the same building, essentially. They're connected. Okay. Apparently I missed you last time, Mr. Pig. This guy looks suspicious. What are you doing? Eating bread in the middle of nowhere. Oh. Are you alright? You look a little distraught. And crazy.
And if I am, what is it to you? Listen, I know you mean well, but no, not now. Please, not now.
What's up, champ? Maybe I can help.
Huh. Help. Who are you? Lorem Waterblade reincarnated?
Actually, yes.
Aye, maybe you could help me, but I think we both know what that really means. You want money.
Damn
right.
Everyone
wants money. It's all that keeps this bloody world moving. That bastard golfer proved it.
He's a golfer?
I shouldn't talk like this to you. But still, please, just let me be. Just go.
No. I want money. Search golfers, silver lords, assortment of... God, read that fucking quick. God damn it. Hang on. Search golfers, silver lords, assortment of goods for things which could belong to Mogar Ironford. What's the problem exactly? The locksmith of Mogar Ironford seems to be burdened with something. While talking with him, he mentioned that a certain golfer has proven that money is all that counts for him. In the end, perhaps I should investigate what this Monger did. Monger? Ironford's Metalworks. Wasn't his name Ironford? Oh, Silverlord. Ironford, Silverlord, it's kind of similar. Let's check in here. Why the fuck not, man? It could be another quest here or something. Hey, buddy! Alright, stop with the and also, why do you have a chicken walking around your house? Again, you are just affirming my belief that you are crazy. Absolutely believe that you are 100% insane, my friend. There doesn't seem much going on here. Count the badass guitar music, though.
What? What do you want?
I don't know! I'm trying to help you! For money! But pretend that I don't want money. But I do. What's this? Have I been here? Have I looked at this? Okay, it just kind of curls around. What about... Wait, is this where I just was? Yeah, okay. What is this? Is this a workbench of some kind? Yes, but I can't use it. I think I hear a child on my right. This is disturbing to me. Oh, it's her again. The fucking bread lady. Damn, that bitch don't love her bread, does she? Alright, what is going on up here? There's nothing? Oh, okay. I love the guitar music. Gatehouse. Yeah, that's where we were before, and then the guards got pissed at us. Greybeard's Potion Parlor. Yeah, we probably can't afford any bloody potions, but, you know, let's go speak to Gandalf the Grey in here, shall we?
All you'll ever need...
You don't even have a beard!
Please, take a look.
You don't have a beard!
Walk blessed.
What do you have in stock, champ?
This and that. Just take a look.
Potions, I'm guessing. Pretty much, yes. You also have a bunch of books for magic, which are quite expensive. God damn it. Sell Ambrosia, which is also expensive. A Vision of Frost, blah, blah, blah. Oh, apparently if you get fully, what's it called? Arcane Fevered. If you get fully fevered, you die. That's what people said. Like, 100% is death. Don't know if that's true. Dude, I love to buy some stuff, but you got, like, teleport scrolls and things. I'm poor, man. I need money. We need to do some
safe
of these quests.
Travels.
We'll still search around a little bit more, see if we can find some more quests, and then, you know, try and hit them all up. What is this? Definitely a woman. What is that? Is she holding... Yeah, she's holding like a deer or something? Like a dead deer in her hands? I don't know what up with that. Maybe she's offering it to a god or something? Look at the light rays. Look at them. Can I take this? Oh, I want that. Bloody violin. That's where someone's gonna be like, Jason, that's not a violin. I'll have you know it's a fiddle. Who the fuck are you? Oh. You're Greybeard. I thought the other dude was following me. The, you know, the guy we literally just got a quest from. That was like, oh, everyone just wants money. That guy. I thought somehow he'd become a companion and I hadn't realized, but no. Alright. So we were just here. I'm going the wrong way. My sense of direction is fucking terrible. That's right, it's a dead end over here. That's kind of annoying. Alright, so I say we hit up some of these quests. Let's do the one to get the this one. The one to get the donkey. The one to get the donkey because that's gonna allow us to travel around quicker to do the other quests. And we won't worry about the main story thing for Jespar just yet. I met Frida Goldhoof in front of Ankh's gates. She offered me to give her best donkey. English. She offered to give me her best donkey for free of charge if I help her find the troll Gnarndalf, which threatens her animals and herself. She told me that I should search near the gate around midnight. Alright, so here's the problem. We can't just wait around. So we kind of need to go back to the inn or something. Well, I guess there was a bed. There's a bed somewhere. I think of the building we were just in. Yeah, it's usually one of those beds. Shit, where was it? I think it was this one. Yeah. Let's go in the potion parlor. I think I could use this guy's bed for some fucking reason, so let's do it if we can. Maybe I'm tripping balls. Yeah, we totally can. Alright, so let's sleep around until, like, we'll go until like 10 just so I have time to actually get there. So if it's 12 now, 10 hours will take me to 10. Genius, I know. Alright, so I will probably meet you outside the city, because I don't know exactly where I need to go, and it's probably going to take me a couple of minutes to get there. So I will bring you back in a second, unless something happens. Okay, welcome back. So it's almost midnight. It's like 10:30, almost 11, I think. And here's the thing. We don't have a map mark of this, which is fair enough. It says, wait around until midnight and look for the troll. It says to look for him. It says, she told me that I should search near the gate around midnight. We're near the gate, but this specifically says in the King's Bay. Is this King's Bay here? I'm gonna have to hope so. The gate's right over there, so I guess we just wait a little bit longer. Again, it's like 10:30, so yeah. I'll bring you back in, you know, another minute and a half. Or however long it takes to get to midnight. And we'll see if we can, see if we can find the troll. Actually, instead of cutting you out and bring you back in like a minute, let's just take a quick detour and look down here, because we haven't searched around this section yet. You don't know, there might be something. Also, is that a big white tree over there? That could be glitching out, or maybe that's something important. It looks important. Looks like a crystal tree or something. I don't think we're going to be able to make it all the way over there and back in time, is the problem. And I don't want to miss this. So let's try not to do anything, you know, too lengthy.
Yes.
Hello, buddy. You know anything about Gnarndalf? Jason wants a donkey. What the bloody hell is that? The fuck, man? Alright, hold the phone. Dude, what the hell is that? It seems to be friendly. And you're all okay with this. Dude, what is this?
Still on the road at this hour of day? I think I have just what you need. A flight right to the next inn.
These are the Mirad things that I keep hearing about. I figured it was some kind of travel system. Apparently that's what it is. That is terrifying. So it's kind of like the Silt Strider, but it flies. Right, what time are we at now? 10:44. Apparently it's going to take a while. God damn it. I mean, I kind of want to fly, but I don't know where it takes me or anything like that. So is this a mirror tower here? I think something popped up. Yeah. So all of these probably have the flying things at them, and you can travel to any of these from any of these, if that makes sense. Okay, that's pretty cool. I like that.
Sir?
I'm not going to use the whole, you know, quick travel thing that we downloaded, the mod, unless we really need to. You know, if there's no decent way of traveling legit, then I'll use it. But other than that, I'm going to try and generally use legit methods. That's the way I do it in Morrowind, you know? If I have to go back really far and there's no decent way of me getting there, then I just use the console to teleport me and just consider that quick traveling. Arc South Quarter, yeah, it's like an hour to go, so I guess since we have searched out this direction, I will bring you back in about a minute or so. Okay, welcome back. I just went to go take a whiz, and I came back, and there's now a map marker down here. Oh, here we go. I think we found the motherfucker. I think we found him. It doesn't look like a troll. I can't see. It looks like a dude. Is that a dude or is it a troll? Are you a troll? That's totally a man. That is most definitely a man.
Kirash, what the... You gave me a scare, damn it. What do you want?
Who the hell are you? Are you Naldolf?
I beg your pardon?
These, grunting noises you make, what are they?
Grunting? I'm praying. By the name of the sun, don't you Shari's have any decency? Shall the ghosts of the sand take you, you ignorant excretion of a desert worm? You rancorous child of a camel? You...
Holy shit, calm down.
What is that?
What is what?
Ah!
Okay, Gnaldorf just appeared out of nowhere. Hold on, fella, I'll save you! You did it! Oh god, he's quite tough. Well, as long as you're distracting him. You know what? Hold the phone here. Hold the phone. Let's get out, summon Mystic Bow. And then, boop! Oh, now you're gonna get it, you son of a bitch. I raised my archery a little tiny bit. Okay, you can stop hitting me now. That hurts quite a bit. So, stop it. Yeah! Get peppered with arrows, son. You don't like the water, do you? No, Gnaldorf. That's a bad Gnaldorf. Oh, we're going for the long shot. Oh, he's fucking stopped. Look at him. Boom, son! Did I get him right in the face? I'm pretty sure I did. Oh, look at that. Look at that shot. Right in the mouth. Alright, what do you have, buddy? You have some troll fat. No, what do I do? No, what do I do? Oh, I can't drag him. He's too heavy. Everyone's too heavy.
What? What the blazes was that?
It's a motherfucking troll, buddy. It looked like a troll to me, you bland son of a bitch.
Oh, really? Saldrin, shield me from your wit. What I mean is, how the heck does a troll get so close to the city gates? These guards are getting sloppier by the week.
Well, he teleported. I saw him. He just came out of nowhere.
I guess I owe you some thanks. Without your help, that would have ended differently. Now, excuse me, I have to get back to the city.
Look at that big-ass crab in the distance. Okay, so report the death to Frida, and yeah, it's the way he said that he's gonna head back to the city, it sounds like maybe he'll actually be there and we can maybe get a reward from him or like another quest or something. Don't know. He actually hasn't headed back to the city, he's just kneeling down. You're not a Drollian, are you?
Kirash, what gave me away? My skin or my accent?
Low from column A, low from column B.
Well, I'll have to work on my disguise then. Jokes aside, I am from Kaira, but I was only 6 years old when my commune came to this country, and I'll have seen my 60th winter next month, so I suppose that makes me as Enderalian as most people around here.
Why did you leave Kira?
Oh, there were many reasons. Suffice it to say that Kaira isn't the glittering, exotic country of dreams and poems that bards make it out to be. I am glad to live here. You can say what you will about Enderal, but at least it's peaceful.
Fair enough. At least we got some EXP from some knowledge. That guy still has an arrow in his face and one in his back. Seems like most of them disappeared, which is a little strange. Alright, whatever. There's one down there. So, yeah, the bow seemed pretty effective compared to the previous bows that we were using. So we could probably sell the old one as well. Alright, so let's go back and get our hands on a goddamn donkey called Walwent. Yeah, damn right. I'm excited about this, man. I want a donkey. Alright, so she's in here. Are we allowed in? No. So I gotta... Alright, I'm gonna go rest in the inn or something. I'll be right back. Actually, there was a bed down there. Son of a bitch, Jason. One second. Alright, welcome back. So, stating the obvious here, it's raining. Hello!
So,
I would like a donkey, please. Yes.
There you are.
You don't need to worry about Gnaldorf anymore. The beast is dead.
Yes, I've heard as much.
Commander Heron.
Oh, gods. This Quirinian Triamgar surely lit some fire under their buttocks.
At least it didn't sound like
but he's right. Just hard times we are in if a troll can roam so close to the walls, while the guards play Morala's dice in the tavern.
Don't mention it.
Anyway, thank you.
Yourself,
I'll sleep a lot better now that this thing is over with. Follow me.
Sweet. Take me to my donkey, bitch. Take me to my donkey. Get out of the way. Get out of the way of her. She's taking me to a donkey. Move. fucking move. Move! I will kill you. Okay. I hate when NPCs do that. Like, you're holding progress on my donkey, man. Look at it. It's majestic and ginormous for a donkey.
Here you go. This is Wellwind. You get him for free, as promised. Take good care of him, will you?
Oh, don't worry. He'll be fine. Is this how I name Wellwind? He will now be called Dave. We have a donkey named Dave! Yeah! I'm stuck. I'm so freaking happy right now, you have no idea. Dave the donkey. It even has alliteration. It's beautiful. Right, so, I'm about to end the episode and just trying to decide which quest we're going to be doing next. I guess we can worry about that next time. Anyway, like I say, I'm going to end it here. I'm very hungry. I'm going to go eat. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, I would appreciate it. And I will see you next time for more Enderal. Good night, everybody, and goodbye.